morning, children.
Good morning.
Today we are going to talk something about the gender sensitization, the project which we are going to take for the partners in learning. So I hope you all have joined the project.
Yes.
And are you all interested in the project?
Yes.
Okay. So I will tell you something about what the project is, its objectives, and how we have to work on it. Now, what exactly is gender sensitization? It is a very hot topic in our country and also in the world scenario where we have to work for it, where we have to bring a change in the society. And for that, I'll tell you what gender sensitization exactly is. The aim of human rights education and gender sensitization is to build a universal culture of human rights through imparting knowledge and skills and the modules of attitude gender sensitization. Even the human rights authority says that all are equal. The males are equal and the female. They have given a right of equality to all. But it is we who have made this discrimination. And why? Because often, first we will see what is the difference between gender and what is the difference between sex. Often it has been observed that gender and sex are misinterpreted as having the same meaning. But it is not having the same meaning. In fact, the definition enhances our clarity to the same. The concept of sex is that a female sex or a male sex, and gender may be defined as follows. Sex refers to the biological difference between women and men. That is, men are different and women are different. They are generally permanent and universal. We cannot change them at all. But what is gender? Gender refers to the socially constructed roles and responsibility of women and men in a given culture. It is the roles and responsibilities what our culture has given or what our society has given, that this work will be permanently done by ladies and this work will be done by the men. This type of discrimination, this type of work concept is coming right from the very beginning, right from our civilization. Yes, we can say that, yes, right from civilization. Then these roles are influenced by perception and expectations arising from the culture. In so many countries, there are different type of culture, which when we will start in our project, we will do that. Then political. In political also, so many countries don't give much uplift. Political. There are so many environmental factors also where ladies cannot do that work. Economic, social and religious factors as well as custom law classes. Gender attitudes and behavior are learned and can be changed. It can be changed according to the society. It is not that it are according to the individual thinking. It is not that we have to change, we have to make a change. It is not a written document, we can make a change in the society. Yes. Why gender equality? Why should we need this equality? Because UNICEF recognizes the human rights principles of equality. It has said that all people are equal. So why this discrimination? And non-discrimination as central to the consideration of gender equality and believes that gender-based discrimination is one of the most ambiguous, it is one of the most non-acceptable form of discrimination that children face. Now most of the children, they are discriminated and they feel frustrated in their life and they cannot go up because of this frustration, and promotes equal outcome for girls, boys, and in policies, programs, partnership and advocacy effort to see contribution to poverty reduction and the protection, survival and development of girls and boys on equal basis. This is told by the UNICEF. Yes. Some of the situations in which we see differences. There are so many factors. You will see that many factors have social difference we can find. Now first is that social. In social field, what are the differences? Different perception of women and men's social roles. Man is seen to be the head of the household is the head. And chief breadwinner. He brings the bread. You see here that your father also in the house, he brings the bread for you all. Okay? He is a earning member of the family. Yes, social discrimination. In the political field also, we see so much of discrimination in men and women. That is, in different way in which women share some power. Earlier it was that he was sharing the power. She was the head of the institution. Yes, she was the president. So we have that, we give power to women also in our society. But so many cases that there are, that ladies are not given all this identify the discrimination. Then it is economic. In economic also there are so many differences where women and men have very lucrative good career, but ladies are not promoted. Like in Air Force, they don't give fighter pilot post is not given to the ladies. Then what is gender sensitization? Gender sensitization, changing behavior and instilling empathy into the view that we hold about our own and the other gender. This is the gender sensitization that we have to look for the other gender also. We have to care for
physical harassment also plus a harassment also.
resources with some labor and earning money. Even this man is earning, her husband or her man is also earning money. They are only biological, there are only biological differences. Now in this 21st century we find that there is only some biological differences in our society. That is, a lady can give birth to a child and a man can have moustaches only. That biological difference is there. No other difference is there in our society. Yes. Except giving birth to a child, women and men are the same. This is social structure it is a natural structure and social structure form. And the role of women and men. Society keeps the separate expectations from both. Society also has some different expectations from ladies also and from men also. Gender discrimination is not done and practically by the society and not by nature. We should abolish this difference which is in the society. Nature, though, of course, nature is having a difference. In nature, we have a difference. We cannot rule out that. But what the society is making the difference, we have to rule out that. And that is why we have taken up this project. And this type of discrimination we should abolish and make an equality of girls and boys in our society. Often women and men can do all the work equally. You have seen that they do all the work equally. Today even IAS officers are ladies also. Today KV principals are also ladies.
Ma'am, we can inform a higher officer about it.
You can complain to the higher officer about it. Or what you can do? Anybody else? Yes, that is face that's written.
Or we can tell him not to do, we can tell him the...
Yes, you can change his mindset. Yes. By what? By giving him a counseling. Okay, you can tell him that they know this is very bad. Why are you troubling those girls? They are like your sisters, they are like your family members. Don't trouble them and talk properly to them. And same thing which you see in your house, suppose you see your father or brother is shouting at your mother or sister, what do you say? Do somebody come out and speak out like that? Huh? You speak out like that, what do you say to your parents or your sister or brother, what do you say? That no, you should not do it. Come out and say, what do you say? Nothing. Bahu or what the daughter-in-law, and they also torture. earlier and they throw her out or something. No, there are so many cases like this which happens. Now, it is that where she will go because she's not having anything to earn. Suppose it is with us, we all have a job and we can just go. But it is not, this type of discrimination has to be abolished. Women are expected to prepare meals. Every time it is that women only cook so. Have you ever seen a male cooking food? Very rarely. When your mommy is not well, then you see your father going to the kitchen and cooking something. That also he doesn't know where the masala is, where the thing is, all these things. So it is there in so many places. And though the man performs his responsibility, and then suppose the food is not cooked, he starts hitting. In so many parts of India, women are killed in the name of witchcraft. This is jadoo aa gaya, bhoot aa gaya, hai na? You will see bhoot bhoot aa gaya. They burn her alive or they give her something. This type of stones marked, this type of all incidents are there. Then in society it has been observed that men have the right to do second marriage also. Have you seen a lady in second marriage? The man will get two wives, three wives as they and then the first wife becomes depressed, and this again is a discrimination. Women don't have any right to take decision. They don't have any right to take decision, and then it becomes difficult for a woman when her ladies who are not educated to come out of that trauma also, because the husband leaves her, what will she do? Where will she go? Her parents don't accept her, her in-laws don't accept her. Then for shelter she has to go. Then next yes, women are. We also feel, yes, we are weak. And the society permits man to control women, and this control turns into violence. He feels, yes, I am supreme authority, and then this violence. To prove this crime, there are a lot of arguments, like this should happen with her, that should happen with her, and if something happens with the lady, all will find, will make a discussion. Uske saath ye hona tha, uske saath wo hona tha, we could do this for her, we could do that for her. Okay? If we really want a balance, take the challenge of all the reasons of violence in the society. We should challenge them, we should face them. Though she also has the right. We should fight behind her. We should give her a chance to do something better. That is what we have to bring out the discrimination. In a nutshell, we can say that we give less importance to women than men, because of which male become head and women are treated as lower. This sort of discrimination we have to remove off. Though women and men possess equal right, but society defines the bias against women. They have equal right, but who is biased? Not a man. Man is never blamed. Woman, ye galti kar di, wo kar di, she's only blamed in the house. If suppose that anything happens in the house, the father will blame the mother. You have done that, tumne aise kiya, you have. We have to fight for it. We have to counsel the